Great. Now that we have learned about the concepts of media, let's apply it to our waterfall content type. The first thing that we need to do is make sure that the media and media library modules are installed. So to do that, click on Extend from the admin toolbar and do a quick search for media. And you'll see that I already have media and media library installed. Make sure that they are enabled on your side as well. And when they are, you'll see that there's a new media types menu item under structure. So structure, media types, if we click that, you'll see these are the default media types provided by Drupal: audio, document, image, remote video, and video. If we, for example, edit the image, we'll see that the media source is image, and it can't be changed once the media item is created. By comparison, let's do a remote video because this is what we'll be adding to our waterfall content type. If we do an edit quick, you'll see this time the media source is remote video. To see the various media sources available by Drupal Core, click on Add Media Type, and you'll see that there are these options: file, video file, audio file, image, remote video. If you need something other than these, you'll need to add a contributed module or make your own, which is beyond the scope of this course. So what we're going to do is we're going to add this remote video field to our waterfall content type. To do that, go to structure, content types, waterfall, and manage the fields of the waterfall content type. So to determine which field we need to add, let's go back to the asset directory under unit 5 again. This time, refer to the content type waterfall content type fields. And if you scroll down a bit, you'll see that the waterfall video is the field that we're adding right now. So copy the label. And again, in the waterfall content type, manage fields, add field, and this time select a reference to media. Copy and paste the waterfall video text. Save and continue. We're going to reference media types, and it's going to be limited to one value. Save field settings. For the help text, I'll refer back to the asset directory and just copy the generic text of a link to a YouTube or Vimeo video, which is rendered as a full video. I'll paste the help text. Now, under the reference type, keep the default reference method, and the media type that we are going to be referring to is remote video. So make sure that remote video is selected. Keep the defaults and save settings. Fantastic. We have saved the waterfall video field. Now what we need to do is add the waterfall videos to our existing waterfall content. To do that, click on Content in the admin toolbar. So what we need to do is we need to add the waterfall videos to these six waterfalls. I'm going to work my way up, starting at Hookah Falls. To do that, I'll just click on Edit. And to find the actual video URL, I'll head back to the asset directory under Unit 5, and I'll click on the page for each waterfall. So under Hookah Falls, if I scroll down a bit, you'll see there's the waterfall video media field. All we need to do is copy this text. Copy, head back, and scroll until you find the waterfall video field. And when you do, click on the Add Media button. This will bring up a list of existing media or the option to add a new media, which we are going to do. So paste the YouTube URL, click Add. It says the media item has been created but has not yet been saved. Fill in any required fields and save it to add it to the media library. Now, our remote video media type does not have any additional fields, so click Save. And you'll notice that now the Hooker Falls, New Zealand by drone video is automatically selected, insert selected, and click save. And now we can check out Hooker Falls again. If we scroll down, we'll see that there is indeed a YouTube video. Now, don't worry about how it looks and the size of it. We can change this later. For now, I'm just going to add the remaining videos to the remaining waterfalls. This time, I'll start with Kite Kite Falls. Fantastic. At this point, we have added the waterfall videos to every waterfall content. Great job. I'll see you in the next video.